Tongan is a great country, but scratch the surface and there's our dirty secret. We keep hurting, even worse, killing our babies. Child abuse costs this country over $2 billion each year, and Māori and Pacific parents figure highly in the statistics. On average, one child is killed every 5 weeks in this country. 11 children have died from child abuse in New Zealand over the past 18 months. 90% of all child deaths are from someone the child knew.
Often, you know, we'll hit them. What do you mean you can't do it? You know, go and do it, and we'll hit them, but we're not giving them the tools to help them.
The problem's so bad, social workers Mali Eric and Siosinita Alofi decided to do something about it.
You know, this is me contributing and wanting to make a difference. No more talk.
Last year, they ran the Incredible Years Parenting Program, an overseas course endorsed by the Ministry of Education. It's a free program that teaches mums and dads to be better parents.
Our role with this program is to provide the skills and the tools for parents to enable them to be to help their children emotionally, socially, academically, you know, being part of their children.
There's no such thing as perfect parents. We are only trying to, you know, to be there the way we parent our kids, and also to be aware of all these values that we, you know, that we are learning about and teaching them.
They don't get paid. Their rewards are in seeing changes. They're grateful to the principal of Gleninus Primary School, who offered them a space to run the course. Parents meet for 2 hours once a week over a 14-week period. Some parents are referred, others volunteer. Either way, doing the program doesn't mean they're bad parents.
In this program, we're not saying that parents don't know how to parent, but it's just enhancing them and look at the strength, you know, the positive practices that we have forgotten.
Tongan-born Daniela Kaivelata is the father of two young boys, Viliami and Siosua. They live in Gleninus in Auckland. Daniela's studying to be a youth worker and jumped at the chance to do this course.
It's getting important to me. On that time, I'm having my kids, and then they get onto that, older one get onto two to 3 years old. And then I start realize how hard of that job. And then when that course was come up, and then I think myself, oh, it's good for me to join the course, because I start seeing I definitely need help.
That included changing the way he thinks about who does what as parents. He realized his new way of thinking is not the same way as he was brought up.
If someone else is trying to be seeing me on that ways of, oh, you're doing change the nappy, and you're doing the washing, and hey, if you think you're tough, that's where you're supposed to be tough on. You know, prepare, and then be harder and get rest for your own family. And then be there for them, if you will.
Meet mother of 13 and grandmother of 8, Cook Islander Api Vairua. She was basically pregnant for 9 years.
I think I got pregnant 12 times, because I got twins. Yeah, I got two set of twins. Yeah, I think I had 85, 86, 87. Then I missed 88, and then 89. Then, you know, it goes down, 92, 93. Miss one. Yeah, number 11, I think. I had another set of two girls. But one died in my stomach, because the doctor said the other one was so weak.
You'd think after 13 kids you wouldn't need to do a parenting course, but not so for Api.
I just want to get more experience, and I want to be like, see like my kids sometimes. I want them to see me, you know, see me do things.
What I remember is that she was really strict we weren't allowed to go to the playground after school. We always had to come home. Other than that, she was, apart from that, she was a good mum. We always had to, like, do our homework and clean up the house. We'd only be allowed to play once we cleaned up the house, and that was only at the back of the house. Yeah. But she was good, she was good. She was strict, but, you know, we learned from her.
So today is our first session. The topic for today is child-directed play. Each day you spend 10 minutes to play and spend quality time with your children. So you get to know your child and your child gets to know. And there's different ways of doing it, because often as we parents, we do the play, we tell them, we give commands, you put this there, here. We never allow our children to come up with their own imagination and drive the play. What are you doing? What would you like to play?
Maybe building a house?
No. Don't build a house now. We do this because, look at the time. Come on, Nita, join in. I've been putting all these things together. Look, it's fun.
It's all right. I'll do something else. Maybe.
No, Nita. No, we have to do this because, I have to go and cook dinner. Now we do another one where Nita will direct the play for us. Okay, Nita, what would you like us to play today?
Oh, Mum, can we build a house, please, Mum?
Okay, you show me how to do it.
You can fit this one in here.
Okay, and I'll hold it?
Yes, please, Mum.
Yeah, it looks big. Who's going to live in the house?
Can Grandma fit in the house, too?
If you want to.
Okay.
That's a good house. That's really good.
I've been born and raised back in Tonga.
Yeah.
And then that game there, it's quite a big different.
Yeah.
It's never happened back home. No, for real. It's more like the if you are parents, if you're father or mother, you're not playing with your kids. It's quite new.
My husband was playing with our two older boys, playing balls, and kicking and all that. All my mom could say, what a waste of time, and my dad, And
what do you think about the parent? If the child's not doing what the parent want, what will,
They force.
Yeah, and if the child still refuse, what do you think the parent would do? That is true, and it's quite common with amongst parents, eh?
I brought up in a tough life when I was a young child. Very tough. Wake up early in the morning, go feed the pig, go in the plantation before I go to school. By the time I get to school, it's
time to sleep.
It's time to come back home. See those times? Because if you don't do it, then you get the stick.
Did your parents ever say to you, thank you, Junior, that's an awesome job?
They're just happy because you've done the job, and that's it. But you don't get any, something like saying, thank you.
And here is the homework.
It's been a big day for the parents, but it doesn't end here. They get homework for the upcoming week.
Make it simple. Even say, play with my child 10 minutes.
But for now, it's a chance for Api and Daniela to reflect on their own parenting styles.
Yeah, it's a lot of new things. Those days, for me, I do reading to my kids. And I take them parks and that, but sitting down and play with them, with the toys and stuff like that, I never do that. I'll take them to the park and have a little snacks and that with them. It's just what I do those days.
Some is different, but some it's a little bit similar. But the whole thing to me, it's I knew it's more benefit for myself and my family, for the best.
It's been 6 weeks since Daniela Kaivelata and Api Vairoa started attending the free Incredible Years parenting program in Glen Innes.
When you pay a child to do what you want, what is the child learning?
Nothing. Yeah, absolutely nothing. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
How does that fit in with our Pacific culture? Do we
bribe our children to work as a family for the well-being and the health of the family.
It's not normal to me to bribe them, like bang them. I'm not paying them to do something, but I give them praise and they are happy.
Sometimes parents, you know, we have said, I'll pay you to clean the dishes. Is that a reward or is that a bribe? Okay, so we're very clear of that.
Mother of 13 and grandmother of 8, Api Vairua, is amazed at how much she is learning about parenting.
I'm much better now, and because to me, it's learned a lot of new things. And then I'm changed, you know. I come home and saying things that I never said to my kids, like you can't reward them with money or to do things for you. You know, I tell my kids, I'll give you a hug and kiss, you know, that's rewarding. And they looked at me, oh, what's wrong with you? Well, you changed, you know, what's wrong with you?
Daniela Kaivelata has also noticed changes with his two boys, especially his oldest son, Viliami, who came to him after he had some trouble at school.
He asked me, oh, can you please give me opportunity? I need to talk to you about something. And then it freaked me out. I was still lying down on my bed, getting ready to sleep. I was thinking it will be something special. And then okay. He looked at me right in my eyes and he said to me, oh, I need to say sorry to you about what I did wrong. And then I'm so sorry about that. But I learned from that and then I will be a good boy. And then I'm so proud of him. And then I'm happy of that program we did. And then I started to see that's the result of what I learned from there.
Our next topic would be rules, responsibilities, and routines, you know? These are the family values that we're having in the home and we want to teach our kids.
Is it important that we must have rules in the house?
Rule, it's very, very important to be there. So that's like the judgment of the whole thing, that's right.
The parents' responsibility to teach their children to do the right things.
I'm sure that's the most important part of a rule, to be disciplined the kids, because the first teacher, it will be the parents at home.
If there's no rules and boundaries in the home, what are we teaching our children, eh?
First up, Rachel for me.
Course member Malia Siua is a single mum to Rachel, Netta and Anna. She too didn't think she needed to do a parenting program, but halfway into the course, she realised she was way off course.
Before I do the course, when I try to discipline my children, like they're scared, if I talk they're scared, they cry. And now when I take the course, when I talk to them, they do straight away. Before I know, I don't want them to join when I'm cooking. I don't want them. And everything here, they want to play. I don't want to. I want to be there to make it everything tidy. For me, I don't want any mess. So that's the before and until now, after the course and still while the course going, I join with my children together in a game, cooking, playing together, and they're happy, they feel happy.
You are good girl. I'm proud of you. You done well, darling.
By becoming better from what I'm a parent before. Now I'm happy with what I have from the course. It really touched my heart how to be a better parent to look after my three children.
When we raise our children with fear, what are they learning? You know, will that help them in their teenage adult life? Because when we give so many commands and you're angry for just the things that they did not complete, we forgot about the things that they have done. Their self-esteem will also go down. If they're not expressing themselves at home, how would that impact? Because they're scared, eh?
They build up more problems for their life because they're hiding things from parents, or when they go out, they fighting, they, you know, hitting the children.
If children can do one thing good, praise them for that thing and spend time talking about the things they did not complete in a nicer way, eh?
All of Le'ota Tuitahi's children are grown up and have left home. She has grandchildren, but they live in Australia, so she practices her newfound skills on her Sunday school kids.
I also understand that we have a very different way of parenting in Tonga growing up, and the discipline was quite physical, whereas in this case there's a lot of various methods in terms of engaging with my children. So that was why I wanted to do the course, learn something new.
As a social worker, Le'ota knows the values of good parenting skills, and she's also aware of the issues facing local Tongan families.
In the area of Tamaki, there have been a lot of concerns about Tongan suicide rate, and that is a big concern for me. As a social worker and as a counsellor, I really believe that there's some serious parenting issues here. And of course, acknowledging it's hard for our families because most of them spend long hours in the factory because of the socioeconomic status. But for us, we have a big job to do. It's quite challenging, but quite fulfilling. So I feel that course has given us more tools to be able to offer our families.
If they say you're going to get a hiding tonight, our children will be stunned, eh? How would that impact our children's self-esteem?
Yeah, they start lying, they start to dishonest, you know, and then if it's going to be end up on that stage, it's going to be worse.
When things go wrong with their lives, would they share with their parents?
No.
They won't share with their parents because we are trying to raise our children in this program, that the skills we're learning, so they grow up to feel confident, to express themselves. Yeah. That's why it's so important, one command, not too many things. Don't give too many command. I want you to do that, I want you to do that. Because you know what happened? They can only remember one thing.
But that is the beauty of this program. We talk to the parents about it. It's not us saying, hey, you need to do time out with your children. We discuss and explore what does time out means to them, and looking at where they come from, and what is hitting. What do children learn from hitting? What are you teaching your children to? Because remember, we are in a different environment.
For facilitators Marley and Nita, the progress in the course is right on target.
We are really, really happy with how they have...
I think that's our payoff, eh?
Yeah, it's... you know, words can't explain, you know, how happy and how grateful that we are, you know, having provided them with that opportunity, you know, to learn more about parenting and for them as well to help themselves with the program. Yeah.